For more Think Action TV, stay right here. Couple of $100. Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Antonio Neves, and this is Think Action TV, and I'm really excited because I'm being joined by Ron J. Williams. In my book, this guy is a master networker. He's the CEO of two companies, including Knodes. And congratulations are in order because you've been named one of Fast Company's 100 most creative people in business. That's a handshake worthy.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Let's get into it. Forget about Fast Company.
Okay.
What has been your approach to relationship building throughout your career?
I actually tend to think of relationship building, no matter what the sphere is, the industry, the relationship, they all wind up being a lot like dating. It's a little bit self-similar. I think people artificially believe that different relationships take dramatically different nutrients to grow and to be nurtured. And the truth is, be thoughtful, be genuine, and find ways to create value for the other person. We're all obviously here to create values for ourselves. That part's easy. The part is understanding in a relationship how you can be helpful and surrounding yourself with people you genuinely enjoy. And so if you put those things together, people you really like, find ways to collaborate and create value for them and be thoughtful and authentic, the relationships will take care of themselves with that in mind.
I would say 75% of people out there go about networking and building relationships the wrong way. They go about it with their hand out seeking something. You mentioned something that's critical, creating meaning and adding value. For that person that doesn't know how they can do that, what are some simple ways to create meaning and add value when you're building a relationship with someone?
Well, I think listening is crucial. You can observe the people at networking events who fancy themselves to be good networkers, but actually suck at it. These are typically the same people who, by the way, give poor introductions, which I think you and I talked about on your blog. And they show up and they stick their hand out and they say, I'm so-and-so, tell me about your business. And they assess for a second and they go, okay, well, here's what I'm doing. And maybe we could work together. And look, we're gonna talk to 50 other people tonight. Tell me a little about yourself. You know, what's going on? What are you into? Why'd you start doing what you're doing? And listen, right? And as you listen, you start to be like, well, cool. I don't even know if we could work together, but I actually have somebody that I think maybe you should meet. You're working on education, and it sounds like maybe you don't have any software competency on your team. I got a guy who's been an advisor to a couple of different startups. I don't want anything. I just want a connection. I want to hook you up because I like what you're working on. You seem like a nice person, and I want you to succeed. And it's really simple because what winds up happening then is people, they associate you with greatness. They associate you with their own success, and they want to see you succeed as well.
Nowadays, listen, we have more networks than ever. We have our work network, we have our family network, we have alumni networks, we have LinkedIn, we have social media networks, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Ron, I mean, Knodes does a lot of work within social networks. How are people not utilizing their networks correctly?
Well, I mean, it was foundational to Knodes. Really, what we realized was that making lists sucks. Coming up with circles and groups sucks because the way that we live our lives is not actually adequately reflected in the ways that social networks are organized. There aren't only a few people I talk to sports about. There aren't only 20 people that I talk to technology about. There are certain aspects of my life that I share with you today, but maybe not tomorrow. There are certain things that bind us together today that didn't yesterday. At some point, you know, everybody's a father. Well, now we've got that in common. We're not dads right now, so we don't have that in common. That's not a tie that binds us. And so what I think is interesting is people think that they are well connected. People think that they are networking effectively when they have 500 plus people on LinkedIn. They got to that 500 plus. They got 1,000 friends. And yet the most trivial example I can think of is you're traveling to London, and yet still you manage to not connect with that roommate that you used to have who moved there, because you don't know that, because you don't have them in your London frame of reference. You manage not to have that business meeting that could be crucial for your business because you're not thinking creatively about how to make sure you stay in contact, to your point you made a second ago, with that, you know, those folks who are in London. These are the ways in which networks are giving the false semblance of being deeply connected, but are failing us. We don't think in fixed orbits. We have to be more active in our network.
Well, Ron J. Williams, thanks for stopping by Think Action TV, man. Congratulations on being named one of Fast Company's 100 most creative people in business, and I'm really happy that I can call this guy a friend. Don't change your phone number just yet, okay?
For sure.
All right. For more Think Action TV, stay right here.